Hi all, this is Sammy with AvidCNC, and this is a quick pro tip video on how to use the CAM setup sheet in your Vectric program. Do you sometimes forget where your zero is in your CAM program, or which router bit is assigned to which tool number for the next tool change? Well, luckily for us, Vectric has a feature built in just for this. The CAM setup sheet generates this document, which is available as a web link. You can also print this out if you'd like to have a hard copy. This is also a great tool for team dynamics, so a programmer can communicate with the CNC machine operator about the material setup, work offset location, and tools used. One of the most essential steps when running a CNC job is to ensure that the corner you zeroed to on your CNC machine matches the corner you selected in the VCarve job setup. You can select the material surface or the machine bed for the Z0, as well as any of the four corners or the center of the material for the XY0. Having the sheet handy while you're setting up your material, work holding, and work offset greatly reduces the chances of making a simple mistake. Great, let's hop into how to use this tool and how to generate a setup sheet. We'll open a new VCarve file and enter our job settings as usual. I'll select a one-sided job. Then I'll enter in our material dimensions. Then we'll select our zero. We'll zero to the material surface. For our XY coordinates, let's zero to the front left corner of the material. Once we're happy with the settings we've selected, go ahead and click OK. Now that you have your job setup complete, go ahead and create the CAD and CAM for your project. I'll use this tool tray project as an example. I've linked a video on how to design, program, and a full walkthrough on how to run this project on your CNC machine in the description below if you're interested in making it yourself. Once we're happy with our design and tool paths that we've programmed, you can export your G-code for the CNC technician. I'll go ahead and export my G-code for this project. I'll choose to export the visible tool paths, select my preferred post-processor, and save the G-code file. At the time of exporting your G-code program, navigate to the setup sheet icon. This will allow you to create a detailed setup sheet in the form of a browser link, which can be sent to the CNC tech with the G-code file or printed out as a hard copy. It's important to re-export the setup sheet with any changes to your toolpaths, as that setup sheet will not update with those changes. I recommend using a detailed file naming convention to ensure that the CNC operator can properly compare the G-code file and the setup sheet. Let's take a more detailed look at the information recorded in the setup sheet. First, we can see a visual of our vector design in the job layout window. The design is color-coded by our layer color assignments. In the material setup window, we're provided with the material dimensions, home and start position, datum position, and Z-safe clearance height. Below this is the toolpath summary, listing out the toolpath names, the tools used, and the estimated run times. Lastly, we have a breakdown of each of the toolpaths, which include the feed rate, plunge rate, spindle speed, router bit selection, path depth, step over, and tool number settings for this particular toolpath. This is a great way to present the summary so you can successfully set up a job or catch any mistakes in the program prior to running the job. The setup sheet creates a great visual for many of the important things you need to know when setting up your project, but the G-code also holds much of this information as well. Let's compare the G-code itself to the setup sheet. We'll open our G-code in a text editor to view it. Reading G-code with the updated AvidCNC post-processor is very simple to do. If you haven't updated your AvidCNC Vectric post-processor recently, I recommend you check for updates quarterly, and I've linked a tutorial on how to do this in the description below. The top of our G-code reads the file name, when it was saved, and the post-processor I selected. The name of the program I labeled ending in _01 to illustrate the version number of that G-code export. I have also saved the setup sheet ending in _01 to demonstrate that these two files were saved together and match in all the settings selected. If I update the G-code program with any changes to the toolpaths or job setup and were to re-export the G-code, I would also save a new job setup sheet with a matching file naming convention. let's go through some of the basics in the code to see where they correspond to our setup sheet. First, we have our material dimensions, the Z origin and XY origin for the project, the home start position, as well as the safe Z clearance height. In the toolpath summary, there's a list of our toolpaths, which is also listed under toolpaths used in this file. The code also indicates the tools and tool numbers used in this file. One feature that the setup sheet provides that is not included in the G-code is the runtime estimates. We can also see where the first pocketing toolpath begins. I'll also note here the T1M6 command. This is indicating a change to tool 1. Each toolpath summary lists the selected tool and the tool number. If a different tool was selected and labeled under tool 2, there would be a T2M6 command. Utilizing the setup sheet can help a CNC operator quickly select the correct tool for the tool change. If you're interested on how to perform a manual tool change, we've linked a tutorial on this in the description below. I hope that you found this tutorial helpful. Make sure to subscribe and turn on notifications for more CNC Pro tip, project, and build videos. Thanks y'all for watching. We can't wait to see what you make, and I'll see you in the shop.